you live in a cold climate like Michigan's, three things in life are certain: death, taxes, and heating bills. Whether you use natural gas, electricity, coal, propane, fuel oil, or wood, it takes money and energy to keep your toes from going numb during the winter. And if you have air conditioning, summer means it's time for cooling bills to replace your heating ones. One way to make your home more energy efficient and put some of that money back in your pocket is with a heat pump. It's a technology that's been in homes for more than 50 years, but that's better than ever for the environment and your wallet. And good news for those of us who live in the north, heat pumps are now strong enough to keep up with most winter weather. Hey there, I'm Alexa Stahl. I'm a science journalist living in Michigan's Upper Peninsula and wanted to understand what the deal really is with heat pumps, what they are, how they work, and why I should care about them. And here's what you should know. In one sentence, heat pumps work by using electricity to take heat from one place and move that heat wherever you want it. So if you want your house to be warmer, a heat pump will move heat from outdoors into your living room. If you want your house to be cooler, it'll move heat from your living room outdoors. The fact that they move heat makes heat pumps different from furnaces, which make heat by burning something or using electricity. Heat pumps can also be used in water heaters and clothes dryers. But how do they move heat from one place to another? And what's so good about them compared to all the other options out there? Here are the basics. Most heat pumps have two main parts. There's an outside unit, which looks similar to an air conditioning box, and there's a smaller indoor unit, or head unit. If you have air ducts, that indoor unit is hooked up to those ducts just like a natural gas, propane, or fuel oil furnace. And if you don't have air ducts, you might get what's called a ductless unit that's mounted to your wall. A heat pump can also be connected to a water-based radiator or underfloor heating system. They're pretty flexible. Whatever setup you have, the outside and inside units are connected by pipes and tubes filled with a super cold liquid refrigerant. And that refrigerant is where the magic happens. Outside, the refrigerant moves through a heat exchanger. Here, it absorbs heat from the outside world, either from the air, the ground, or from water, depending on the model. Now, if you're thinking, hey, there's no heat outside in February, here's the key. The refrigerant is even colder than the air, and on its own, heat always moves from warmer places to colder ones, even when that warmer place is minus 10 degrees Fahrenheit. Heat pumps do have to work harder in the winter and are less efficient as it gets colder, but they do work all year in most climates. Newer models work when it's as cold as minus 10 degrees Fahrenheit, and they're not affected by wind chill. So even if that minus 10 degree day feels like minus 25, a heat pump keeps on keeping on. You can also supplement heat pumps with a backup furnace or electric resistance heating if you live in an especially cold climate. Anyway, going back to our refrigerant liquid, it absorbs heat and then boils into a gas. Then a compressor squeezes that gas, making it hotter, more than 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Inside, that hot gas then goes through a second heat exchanger, and there the heat from the gas gets blown into your home. The gas itself stays in the pipes, cools down, turns back into a liquid, and ultimately, the whole thing starts all over again. What's cool about heat pumps is that this process can also go in reverse and act like an air conditioner, absorbing heat from inside and taking it outdoors. So you only need one system to stay warm and keep cool. But here's the big thing to know. Compared to other systems, heat pumps are really efficient. That means every dollar you spend trying to heat or cool your home goes further. For example, let's say you burn wood for heat. Not all of the energy from that wood fire goes into heating your home. Anywhere from 17 to 49% of the energy is wasted and escapes through things like the chimney. So a wood furnace has an overall efficiency of 51 to 83%. Natural gas furnaces can be better, but even a brand new natural gas furnace wastes about 3 to 22% of its energy. And old systems can waste up to 44%. Heat pumps are different. Instead of burning something to make heat, they move heat from one place to another. And that means that they can do a lot more work with the same amount of energy. The numbers depend on the temperature outside, but heat pumps can be anywhere from 100 to 400% efficient. In other words, for every unit of electricity you put in, a heat pump can move up to 4 units of equivalent heat. And since they're a heating and cooling system in one, that also means you only have one main system to take care of. You can think of it this way. Imagine you're moving into a new house and you have $100 to spend on furnishing your living room. You could give that money to a carpenter and ask them to build you all new stuff, but your money wouldn't go very far. Or you could pay movers to haul over your existing furniture from your old place and you'd get a lot more out of it. It's much easier to move something that already exists than to generate something new. The same is true for heat pumps. The heat is already out there, they're just bringing it indoors. That takes less energy and therefore less money. So even though heat pumps tend to be more expensive up front, they can save the average homeowner anywhere from about $100 to more than $900 per year, depending on what your current system is. And that's not counting all the rebates that exist right now. Also, heat pumps can be a lot better for the environment, which might be a big motivation for you. Burning natural gas will always put pollutants and greenhouse gases into the air, but the electricity for a heat pump doesn't have to. It can come from cleaner, low-carbon places like hydroelectric, solar, and wind power. And if you're someone who does think about carbon emissions, because they're so efficient, heat pumps can reduce your annual emissions by anywhere from 1.1 to 7 tons per year. For comparison, going vegan for a whole year will only cut your carbon footprint by an average of 1 ton. So, there's your intro to heat pumps. While they are often more expensive up front, they can save you money in the long run and can also reduce air pollution in your community and the larger world. And if you want more info on how these things work, there's more on the gassy, wonderful world of heat pumps in the next video in this series. See you then! This educational heat pump video is brought to you by the Upper Peninsula Power Company's Energy Efficiency Program.